Welcome to my channel Crochet with Jana. Today I would like to show you small oval doily. My doily is measured about 17 inches long and about 9 inches wide. I am using crochet hook size 1.5 millimeters and the thread similar to size 10, so 280 meters of a thread equals about 50 grams. So let's get started. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot. Then chain of 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. Slip stitch in first chain stitch to form meringue. And we are going to start our first round by making chain 1, and into the circle we have to make 16 single crochets, so chain 1 from the beginning is not counting as a stitch. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. If you would like to, you can also work one single crochet in each chain stitch. At the end we need to skip chain 1 and we are making slip stitch in our first single crochet. So this is our first round. Second round, now we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the same stitch we have to make one more double crochet. Chain of 2, then we need to skip next double crochet, into the third one, 3 double crochets, we need to skip the next single crochet, because in our last one round we've done single crochets. Chain of 2, then again we have to skip next single crochet, into the second 2 double crochets. So we've done 2, then 3, now 2 again. Chain of 2, then we have to skip first single crochet, into the second, now 3 double crochets again. So one time we are making 2 double crochets and the next time 3 double crochets. Chain of 2. Now we have to skip first one and into the second 2 double crochets again. Chain of 2, then we have to skip first single crochet into the next one, 3. So now we have to work the same pattern all the way around. So at the end we should have 8 groups. 4 groups of 2 double crochets and 4 groups of 3 double crochets, and between each group chain 2 space. At the end of our round, I've done slip stitch in third chain stitch of the first double crochet, and now we are going to start by making chain of 3. Again as a first double crochet, then one double crochet in next stitch. Chain of 2. Now we've got group of 3 double crochets, so 2 double crochets in first one, 1 double crochet in next one, and 2 double crochets in last one. So now we've got group of 5 double crochets. Chain of 2, then when we've got group of 2 double crochets, we have to work 1 double crochet in each stitch, 1 and 2. Chain of 2, then we've got group of 3 double crochets, so again 2 double crochets in first stitch, 1 double crochet in next one, and 2 double crochets in last one. So we've got group of 5 double crochets again. Now chain of 2, and we've got group of 2 double crochets. So we have to work 1 double crochet in each double crochet. So when we've got group of 3 double crochets, now we have to work group of 5 double crochets. When we've got group of 2 double crochets, only 2, and chain 2 space between each group again. Round number 4. We are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then one more double crochet in the same stitch. So we've got 2 double crochets in our first double crochet in next one. So now we've got group of 3 double crochets, chain of 2. When we've got group of 5 double crochets, in first double crochet we have to make 2 double crochets. Then 1 double crochet in next 3. 2 and 3. And in last one we have to make 2 double crochets again. So we've got 1. And second. So now we've got group of 7 double crochets, chain of 2, and again group of 2 double crochets from last one round, 2 double crochets in first one, 1 double crochet in next, chain of 2. And now we have to repeat. So now we've got 2 double crochets in first, 1 in next 3, and 2 double crochets in last one. So group of 3 double crochets, chain 2, then group of 7 double crochets, chain of 2, group of 3, group of 7, and all the way around. Now we've got round number 5, so chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then in next 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet in each stitch. Chain of 2. Now we've got group of 7 double crochets. In first double crochet we have to make 2 double crochets again, then in next 5 1 double crochet in each stitch, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then in our last double crochet 2 double crochets again, 1 and 2. So we've got 9 double crochets. Now chain of 2. In next 3 double crochets, 1 double crochet. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2. Now we have to repeat. So 2 double crochets in first one, 1 double crochet in next 5. Then 2 double crochets in last one. So now we've got groups of 9 double crochets, chain 2, and then groups of 3 double crochets and also chain of 2. Round number 6. We are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 2 double crochets in second double crochet. Now 1 double crochet in third one. So now we've got group of 4 double crochets, chain of 2. Now in first double crochet we have to work 2 double crochets again, 1 and 2. Then in next 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet, 1 and 1, chain of 2. So after group of 4 double crochets, chain of 2, then we have to skip next double crochet, and into the second we have to make 3 double crochets in one stitch. So 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2. Now we have to skip next double crochet, in next 2 1, 1 and 1, and into the last one we've got 2 double crochets. So group of 4 double crochets, then we have to skip double crochet, group of 3 double crochets and we have to skip 1 double crochet, then group of 4 double crochets as well. Chain of 2 and we are going to repeat. So in our first double crochet we have to make 1 double crochet, then 2 double crochets in next one, 1 and 2, and 1 double crochet in next. Chain of 2 and again we are going to repeat what we've done here. So 4 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets, chain 2, and another 4 double crochets. Round number 7, we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. So we've got group of 4 double crochets again. Chain of 2, then we are going to the next group of 4 double crochets and again we are going to make 1 double crochet in each stitch. 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 2. Now we've got group of 3 double crochets. So in first double crochet we are going to make 2 double crochets. Then 1 double crochet in next stitch and 2 double crochets in next double crochet. Chain of 2. In next 4 double crochets we have to make 1 double crochet. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 2. Now we've got another 4 double crochets, so we are going to make 1 double crochet in each stitch again. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 2 and from now we are going actually continue what we've done from the beginning. So we've got second group of, or actually now in a row, third group of 4 double crochets. So we are going to make 1 double crochet in each stitch again, then chain of 2 and we've got group of 3 double crochets. So then we are going to make group of 5 double crochets. So 2 double crochets, 1 and 2 double crochets. So in each group, when we've got 4 double crochets, we have to work 1 double crochet in each stitch, then chain of 2. Only when we've got 3 double crochets, we are going to make increase in first and last double crochet to have 5 double crochets in a row. Round number 8. We are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 more double crochet in the same stitch. Then 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. One, two, and three. Then chain of 2. So now we've got group of 5 double crochets. And again, 2 double crochets in first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 3 stitches. Chain of 2. Now we've got group of 5 double crochets from the previous round. In first double crochet we are going to make 2 double crochets, then 1 double crochet in next 3. And 2 double crochets in next stitch. So now we've got group of 7 double crochets, chain of 2. And now we have to make 1 double crochet in first 3 double crochets. Two double crochets in next double crochet. Chain of 2, then again 2 double crochets in first one. So actually basically this is the main thing as we are working 2 double crochets in 1 double crochet is that we have to increase our number of double crochets to 5. So it actually doesn't really matter where we are working an increase, at the beginning of our group or at the end. We can even add extra double crochet in the middle. Only what we have to do is that we need to make 5 double crochets instead of 5. So chain of 2 and now for example we can work double crochet in first one, then 2 double crochets in second and another 1 double crochet in another 2 double crochets. So 5 double crochets in a row again, chain of 2. And when we've got our 5 double crochets from the previous round. We are going to make 2 double crochets in first one definitely, then 1 double crochet in next 3, and 2 double crochets in last. So again, 7 double crochets. So now we need to continue this pattern all the way around. So we've got 3 groups of 5 double crochets in a row, and then group of 7 double crochets. Round number 9, we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain of 2. Then we are going to the next group of 5 double crochets, and we have to work 1 double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Chain of 2 again. Now we've got group of 7 double crochets. In first double crochet we have to make 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. Then in next 5 double crochets, 1 double crochet in each, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then in last one, 2 double crochets again, 1 and 2. So we've got group of 9 double crochets now, chain of 2, and we've got 3 groups of 5 double crochets. So we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning, 1 double crochet in each double crochet, and chain 2 spaces between until next group of 7 double crochets. Here in first and the last one we have to work 2 double crochets, and in a middle 5, 1 double crochet. So exactly what we've done here. So in each group of 5 double crochets we should have 5 double crochets again. When we had 7, now we are making increase in first and the last double crochet, and then 5 double crochets in next 3 groups again. Round number 10, we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next stitch. In our third double crochet, so exactly at the center, 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, then 1 double crochet in next 2 stitches. So we've got group of 6 double crochets. This is actually the middle group of our 5 double crochets, so that's why we've done 2 double crochets in our middle stitch. Now chain of 2. Now into the third one we have to work 2 double crochets in first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain of 2. Now we've got group of 9 double crochets. In first double crochet we have to make 2 double crochets, then in next 3, 1 double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2, and 3. In 5th, so exactly at the center, we need to make V-stitch. So double crochet, chain 2, and 1 more double crochet. In next 3 double crochets, 1 double crochet, 1, 2, and 3. And in our last one, 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. So now on both sides we've got groups of 6 double crochets and chain 2 space exactly in the middle. Now chain of 2. Now we have to make 1 double crochet in first 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then 2 double crochets in our last one, 1 and 2. So we've got completely opposite side what we've done 2 seconds ago. We just started by 2 and then 4 single double crochets. Now we've got first 4 single double crochet and then 2. Chain of 2, now 1 double crochet in first 2 double crochets. Two double crochets in third one and one double crochet in next two. Chain of 2. Now we have to make 2 double crochets in first one and then in next 4 one double crochet. So from now we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So after our 4 double crochets, we have to make 2 double crochets in first one, 1 in next 3, in 5th V-stitch, then 1 double crochet in next 3 and in last one 2 double crochets. So now we have to continue all the way around. Now we've got round number 11 and this is actually the last one round in this project. So we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain of 2, then 1 double crochet in next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Chain of 2, 1 double crochet in next 6 stitches. So as you can see now we are working 1 double crochet in each stitch from our previous round. We are not making any increases. We've got exactly the same number of double crochets. So after the 6th double crochet now where we got chain 2, this is only the difference. So we need to make chain of 2, double crochet in chain 2 space. Chain of 2, then again 1 double crochet in next 6 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And from now again chain of 2, then we have to work 1 double crochet in each next 6 double crochets, chain 2, 1 double crochet in next 6 double crochets, chain 2, 1 double crochet in next 6 double crochets, chain 2, then in next 6, and then when we've got chain of 2 in the middle, we have to work exactly what we've done a few seconds ago. So chain 2, double crochet in chain 2 space, and then another chain of 2. So at the end we can fasten off and cut the yarn because the next part we are going to start working in rows and we are going to start from the center over here. So now we are going to start working on our second part. So as I said, at the end we can fasten off and cut the yarn. Now we are going to start working in rows. So as you remember, we've got 4 parts. And 4 times we've got chain 2, double crochet and then chain 2. So the first one part we can start in any place, but the second one, which I will make in a minute, we have to work exactly on the opposite side. So we have to skip one part and then you are going to the second one. So this is my first one and you are able to see how it's supposed to gonna look like at the end. And now I'm going to turn my work upside down and we are going to start first row. So we have to join by making slip stitch in first double crochet before chain 2 space, first chain 2 space. So because it's a slip stitch, I will make little knot first, then I'm going to insert my crochet hook and work slip stitch. Our first row, we are going to start by making chain of 2, then we have to go directly to the double crochet, so chain 2 space we have to skip and we need to make double crochet, chain 2 and one more double crochet. So we've got B stitch. Now chain of 2 again, then we need to skip another 2 chain stitches and we have to work slip stitch in first double crochet after our chain 2 space. So double so we've got chain 2, double crochet, chain 2, double crochet and another chain 2. Now we have to make slip stitch in next 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. And we are going to start row number 2, so we have to turn our work. We are going directly to the first chain 2 space. Now we have to make 3 double crochets in that chain. So 1 2 and 3. Double crochet into the double crochet, then 3 double crochets in next chain 2 space. 1 2 and 3. Double crochet in next double crochet. And in our last chain 2 space, 3 double crochets again. 1, 2, and 3. So in total we should have 11 double crochets. Now we have to keep double crochet the first one. We've done slip stitch before, then another 2, and we have to work slip stitch into the third, but in total into the fourth if we are counting from the beginning, then slip stitch in next 2 double crochets as well. So we are exactly in our last double crochet of this group. And we have to start third round, so we are going to turn our work again and we are going directly to our first double crochet. 2 double crochets now in each double crochet from our previous row. So I've done 2 double crochets into the first one. Now 2 double crochets into the second. Two double crochets into the third. Then 2 double crochets into the fourth and fifth, sixth until our last 11th double crochet. So at the end we should have 22 double crochets in total, and then I will go back to you to show you what we have to do next. At the end of our row, now we are going to skip next 2 double crochets and we have to work slip stitch into the third row, so exactly into the last one. Now we need to make slip stitch in next 2 chain stitches and slip stitch in first double crochet. Now row number 4, we have to start by making chain of 2 and then we are going to turn our work. Now we have to skip first double crochet and into the second we have to make double crochet again. Chain of 2, skip first double crochet, 1 double crochet in second. Chain 2, skip first double crochet, double crochet into the second. Chain of 2, skip first double crochet into the second. Chain 2, skip first double crochet into the second. And now we have to repeat this pattern to the last double crochet. So each time we have to skip first double crochet and work with chain 2 spaces. After our last double crochet, now we are going to make chain of 2, then we have to skip chain 2 space and we need to make slip stitch in next 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Now we have to turn our work and we are going to start row number 5. In chain 2 space we have to make 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3. Then double crochet in next double crochet. 3 double crochets in next chain 2 space, 1, 2 and 3, then double crochet in next double crochet. Three double crochets in next chain space. One, two, and three. Then double crochet in next double crochet. And now this pattern we are going to repeat all the way across. So in each chain space we need to make three double crochets and double crochet in each next double crochet. After our last double crochet, now we are going to skip next two double crochets, and in our last three double crochets we are going to make slip stitch. 1, 2, and 3. Now we are going to start row number 6, and we have to make one double crochet in each double crochet from our previous row. So basically we should have exactly the same number of double crochets as we did before. So one double crochet in each stitch all the way across. At the end of our row we should have 47 double crochets, so the same with the previous one. And now we are going to skip the next two double crochets. Now we have to work slip stitch into the third one, so into the last double crochet of this group. Then slip stitch in next two chain stitches. And now we have to make chain of two, then we are going to turn our work. Now we have to skip first double crochet, one double crochet into the second. Chain of two, skip first double crochet into the second. Chain of two, skip first double crochet into the second. Chain two, skip first double crochet into the second. Chain two, skip first double crochet into the second. So now we have to repeat this pattern all the way across. At the end of our round we should have 23 double crochets. At the end of our row we are going to make the last chain two, then we have to skip chain two space from the previous round. Now we need to make slip stitch in next three double crochets. And we are going directly our next row, row number 8. Now we have to turn our work. In chain two space now we have to make two double crochets. Then one double crochet into the double crochet. And again, two double crochets in chain space. Then double crochet into the double crochet. Two double crochets in chain space. Then double crochet into the double crochet. So now we have to repeat this pattern again all the way across. In each chain two space we have to work two double crochets and double crochet in each double crochet. At the end of our round, after the last double crochet, now we have to skip our first two double crochets and we need to work slip stitch in next four. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we are going to start our row number 9. So we have to turn our work and we are going to make one double crochet in each double crochet from our previous row. So again we should have exactly the same number of stitches as we've done in our previous row. So one double crochet in each double crochet. So continue all the way across. At the end of our round, we are going to skip next two double crochets. Now we have to work slip stitch into the last one, into the third one, then slip stitch in next two chain stitches. Now we are going to make chain of two and we have to start the last one row, so row number 10. We are going to skip our first double crochet, one double crochet into the second, chain of two, skip first one, double crochet into the second, chain two, skip first one, double crochet into the second, chain two, skip first one, double crochet into the second, chain two, then again we have to skip first one, double crochet into the second. And this pattern we are going to continue all the way across, so until our next double crochet. Later on I will go back to you to show you how we need to finish this row and we are going to start on our border. At the end of our round we are going to make the last chain two and we have to work slip stitch in second chain of our chain two space from the last one round. So make sure that we are not working slip stitch in a double crochet, because double crochet we are going to use in first round of our border. So slip stitch in chain two and now we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So our last one row is done. In a minute I will go back to you to show you what we have to do with our border. Now we are going to start first round of our border. So we need to join into the first double crochet after as we've done slip stitch into the second chain stitch. So in the center part we've got four groups of six double crochets. So we have to join into the first double crochet of our first part, chain of three as a first double crochet. Now into the next double crochet we have to work one double crochet as well. Into the third one we are going to make two double crochets. Then one double crochet in next three double crochets. So we are going to have group of seven double crochets. Now chain of two, double crochet in chain space, chain of two, and we are going to repeat what we've done before. So in first two double crochets we have to work one double crochet, in third one two double crochets in one stitch and one double crochet in next three stitches. Chain of two, now double crochet into the double crochet, so chain two space you have to skip, chain of two and double crochet in next double crochet, so another chain two we have to skip as well, double crochet in next double crochet, and again in third one we have to make two double crochets, so one and two. So each time when we've got group of six double crochets we have to make increase in our third double crochet and then we've got group of seven double crochets. Now chain of two, double crochet in chain two space. So as you can see, if we've got only chain two space we are going to work double crochet in that chain space, but here we had two, so we've done double crochet in double crochet between. Now one more time, chain of two, double crochet in first two double crochets, two double crochets into the third one, one double crochet in next three double crochets. Two and three. So we've got 4 groups of 7 double crochets and 3 single double crochets between as well. So 6 chain 2 spaces. Now we are going directly to the first double crochet after our chain 2 space. So we need to make double crochet in first double crochet after first chain 2 space. So here we've done slip stitch, then chain 2, and we've got double crochet. From now we need to repeat this pattern. So here we haven't got any chain spaces, we are making double crochet and another double crochet straight away. Now chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2 one more time because we done 2 chain 2 spaces before as well, then double crochet in next double crochet. And now we are going to make another group of 7 double crochets. So this is the first one. Now 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 double crochet in next double crochet, 2 double crochets in next chain 2 space, and 1 double crochet in next double crochet. So we've got group of 7 double crochets. Now chain of 2, then we have to skip chain 2 space, double crochet in next double crochet, chain of 2 again, double crochet in next double crochet, and again we need to make another group of 7 double crochets. So 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 double crochet in next double crochet, 2 double crochets in next chain 2 space, and double crochet in next double crochet. Now we are going to repeat chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, and we have to make another group of 7 double crochets. So from now this is our whole pattern. 2 chain 2 spaces, then group of 7 double crochets to the end of this part. At the end I will go back to you to show you what we have to do over here, and then we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So now I am on my opposite side. So from the part as we've done our double crochet in first double crochet, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 groups of 7 double crochets. So I've done my last 2 chain 2 spaces and double crochet in last double crochet before our last chain 2. Now we have to repeat what we've done here. So after our last double crochets, we are going directly to the group of 6 double crochets, and we have to make double crochet in first one, then double crochet into the second, again 2 double crochets into the third, and from now we are going to repeat our pattern exactly from the beginning. So we should have another 4 groups of 7 double crochets in space when we've got chain 2. We have to work chain 2 and then double crochet. So our work will be looks exactly as we've done on our opposite side. At the end we are going to make double crochet in last double crochet before last chain 2 space, and then we have to work slip stitch into the first one. Now we are going to start second round. So after our last double crochet I've done slip stitch in my first one. Now chain of 3 as a first double crochet and 1 double crochet in next 6 double crochets. So again in this round we are going to have groups of 7 double crochets, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7. Now chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets. So each time we have to skip our chain 2 spaces from the previous round. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And again, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2 and 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2 and 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And now we are going to make chain of 2, then we have to skip the first double crochet. We are going directly to the second to continue with our pattern. So chain 2, double crochet, but into the second double crochet, chain 2 and 1 double crochet in next 7 double crochets again. So apart from this double crochet, our pattern is staying exactly the same. So now all the time we should have groups of 7 double crochets, then chain 2 double crochet and then chain 2 as again. So the first double crochet, or if we are talking about of our opposite side, it's gonna be last one, we have to skip. So we have to make double crochet into the first double crochet after group of 7 double crochets, then chain 2 and we are going directly to the next group of 7 double crochets as we've done here. So all the time we should have 7 double crochets, then 2 chain 2 spaces. Now we are going to start round number 3 by making slip stitch in our second double crochet. So this is mean that first double crochet we have to skip. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 3, single crochet in double crochet, so chain 2 space and the last double crochet we have to skip. So now we've got group of 5 double crochets, single crochet in double crochet after chain 2 space, chain of 3 again and one more single crochet in the same double crochet. Chain of 3. Now again we have to skip chain 2 space and first double crochet, 1 double crochet in next 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain 3, single crochet in first double crochet, chain 3, then single crochet into the same double crochet. So always we have to skip the last and the first double crochet of each group of 7 double crochets from our previous round, and we have to make chain 3, then small V stitch, so single crochet, chain 3 and single crochet into the double crochet between 2 chain spaces, and then again chain of 3. Now again we have to skip first double crochet, 1 double crochet in next 5 double crochets. 2, 3, 4 and 5. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. Round number 4. We are going to start by making slip stitch into the second double crochet. So the first one we are going to skip again. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 1 double crochet in next 2 stitches. So now we've got group of 3 double crochets. The last one double crochet we are going to skip as well. Chain of 2. And now into the V stitch. So chain 3, first chain 3 space and the last double crochet you have to skip. So into the V stitch, we are going to make treble crochet, then chain 1. Treble crochet again, chain 1. Treble crochet, chain 1. Treble crochet, chain 1, and one more treble crochet. So we've got 5 treble crochets and 4 chain 1 spaces between. Now chain of 2, and we are going to our group of 5 double crochets. Now we have to skip the first one, and then in next 3, 1 double crochet. So exactly the same as we've done at the beginning of our round. So now again, chain of 2, and we have to go to the next V stitch, so we are going to skip double crochet, first chain 3 space, and we have to make another 5 treble crochets and chain 1 between, so 4 chain 1 spaces. Good, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now we are going to continue this pattern all the way around. Groups of 3 double crochets, then chain 2, 5 treble crochets and 4 chain 1 spaces, and then another chain of 2. Now we are going to start our last one round, round number 5. After slip stitch in first double crochet, now we have to work slip stitch into the second. So this is mean that our first double crochet we have to skip. Chain 1, single crochet in second double crochet. Then so the same as we've done the slip stitch. Then we have to skip third one and 2 single crochets in chain 2 space. Now we are going to skip treble crochet, 2 single crochets in first chain 1 space, then we have to skip next treble crochet and 2 single crochets in next chain 1 space, so the second one. Now chain of 3, then we have to skip next treble crochet, 2 single crochets in next one. Then we have to skip next treble crochets, 2 single crochets in next one. And again, we have to skip last treble crochet and 2 single crochets in next chain 2 space. From now we are going to repeat. So we are going to skip first double crochet, single crochet into the second. Then we have to skip next double crochet and 2 single crochets in next chain 2 space. And from now we have to skip each treble crochet. Then we have to work 2 single crochets in each chain 1 space. But after the second chain 1 space, so the fourth double crochet, single crochet, we are going to make chain 3 space. And this is actually whole pattern for this round. At the end we have to work slip stitch in our first single crochet, so after 2 single crochets in last chain 2 space, then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So our project will be done. Thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. I hope you like this type of project. If yes, just let me in the comment section below, put your thumbs up. I wish you have a nice day and see you in the next tutorial.